heard about four or five of you. Good morning, Northside. And good morning to our visitors. We're so happy to have you join us on this lovely occasion, Mother's Day. Today is a very, very special day. You are in for a blessing, blessing, blessing. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Amen. It's the day that we are honoring our mothers. And that's all right. I like that. We got a divorce in the house. Amen. I would like to see the hands of you who still have a living mother. Let me see your hands. Oh, looky here. Let me tell you. Praise God. Give yourselves a hand. Let's give yourselves a hand. You are blessed. You are blessed beyond measure. This Mother's Day is the first Mother's Day I have been without my mother. Many of you know I lost my mother last year, about a year ago in June. But I have very, very precious memories. And today is not a sad occasion for me because I can just reflect back over the years and just remember all of the things that my mother deposited in my life, positive things. So I think about those things, not that she's gone, but I believe today she's looking, she's smiling down on me. So I've got to remember those things. We would like to salute our mothers today, young, old, and all those in between, because you are so special. Someone said that God could not be everywhere, so he created mothers. Now we know that God is omnipresent, but in the human, God couldn't be everywhere. So there is no substitute for mothers. Now many people say that motherhood, and I believe this, that motherhood is the most challenging, being a mother is the most challenging job you can have on the face of the earth. No, it's not the policeman. No, it's not, well, I'm not going to say it's not the president, but if you could look at all of the occupations, it's not any of those. I believe that it's motherhood, because it's mothers that are the ones that really help to mold and shape the lives of the young ones. Mothers are the most resilient creatures, I believe, of mankind, the most resilient. And God certainly endowed us with the ability to multitask. How many of you know this way? Do many, many things at once. Okay, and on occasions, motherhood sometimes is just simply overwhelming. How many of you don't have to raise your hands, during the course of rearing your children, sometimes you just run your hand and say, I don't know what to say, I don't know what to do, you feel like throwing in the towel. But you don't do that, because you have a commitment. Yet, through prayers, tears, encouragements, the joys and the sorrows, gratifications, challenges, we manage to surmount all of the difficulties. So I want to salute you mothers today. Now I would like to, as I look across the audience, I want to recognize, I believe, the oldest mother in the house. And we're going to ask Sister Marvelina Elam to stand. I believe she's the oldest mother in the house. But I believe she is, and she has over the years done such a wonderful job, and we want to commend you, Mother Elam, for your tremendous job. She retired last year, and she is still working for the Lord and just a beautiful person, so we want to commend her. We're going to move right rapidly because we want to give all the time for her. We have a dynamic speaker, so we want you to get ready, but before we bring her, we're going to do something a little different this year. Usually we have mothers to give testimonies who reared their children and they've told about what it was like rearing them. And they are grown and gone. But we asked this year for young mothers who's in the process of it, rearing their children, to tell us what it's like. Tell us the challenges. Tell us about the difficulties you're having. Tell us how the responsibilities, how, what it's like being a mother. What is it like being a wife? What is it like being a woman to your lover, your husband, and maybe even a career woman? What is it like? So we have asked four beautiful young ladies to come to us this morning. All of them are in various stages. Some have very, very young children, and some have older, but they are still in the process of rearing them, and all of their children are still in the home. So we're going to ask you to welcome these young ladies. If you would come just back to back, Jessica Van, Kristen Clark, Evie Bowie, and Tia Hill. And just, we ask that you do just 5 minutes, because we want to give room for our speaker, who we know have lots of gems of wisdom for us today. So would you come in that order again? Jessica Van, Kristen Clark, Evie Bowie, and Tia Hill. Amen. Amen. Tell us, we just want to keep it real now.
Well, I don't want to scare anybody that doesn't have children. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers. I've only been a mother for 4 years. My oldest son just turned 4, and my baby is 18 months. So things are hectic in my life. When I was younger, I prided myself on getting all my sleep all the time. If it was 9 o'clock, I was going to sleep. I didn't care who was over, what was going on, or what hadn't been done. I'm going to sleep. And I think that's the first thing that I had to go ahead and realize that I was going to have to give up. Not so much with Bradley, because, you know, I could sleep when he was sleeping. But when Chelsea was born, and Chelsea would keep me up all night till 3:30 in the morning, and Bradley would wake up at 5 and just be up. And then when Bradley went to sleep, Chelsea woke up. And when Chelsea woke up, Bradley was asleep. It was just, oh. And, you know, I would look back and be like, you know, I'm weak. I don't know what's going on. It's like, I haven't eaten today. I haven't slept. Did I take a shower? No, I don't think so. And I remember telling Marco one day, he came home, he was like, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, you know, I'm just so tired and worn out. You know, I feel like I got to hire a babysitter just to take a shower. You know, I just can't just do what I want to do when I want to do it. But, you know, I'm thankful. I have two healthy children who are full of energy. And I thank God for that. And I also thank God for my mother. And my dad too. We'll talk about him in June, but the example that she set, and I can say, okay, well, my mom raised three kids, and she seemed to come out of this thing unscathed and still sane. And, you know, my grandmother raised four, and I see Sister Hill, you know, so I guess I'll survive this. I will, you know. But you know, it's a joy and a pleasure. You know, I multitask, and I left my job after Chelsea was born, and I thought, you know, oh, well, I'll take a nap, and I think I may have taken a nap, really a nap, maybe two, since she's been born. But it's a pleasure. It's so inspiring to see them come alive and start to learn stuff and start to put things together. And put two and two together, and Bradley's like, you know, still, okay, so why did Jesus die on the cross, and what's the sin, you know? And so things are starting to come together, and Jessica's like, oh, I guess this is working, this is cool, I can do this. But I just thank God for, you know, all my examples that I had in front of me, and also just the preparation that I had. Pastor Hill asked me to mention some of the things in the ministry that helped me, and when Marco and I were getting married, we went through the marriage classes. We went through financial peace, which I would recommend for anybody who wants to control their money and not let money control them, or the lack of money control them. I would really recommend the financial peace class, because that took one weight off of our shoulders. We weren't worried about where diapers were coming and where the food was coming and all that kind of stuff, because we put those things already in order. So I think that's all I have to say, and unless I need to say more. So.
Kind of the same lines, because we all know I definitely have my hands full with my three, And the time is really like one of the biggest things that we had to, that I had to give up, you know, especially, you know, being, when I came, I was a basketball player, so, you know, being able to spend all my time playing basketball and doing the things that I loved. And, you know, my goal when I graduated was to be a teacher and to be a basketball coach and to go back and get my master's after, well, Christopher was born while I was in college, and I said, well, when Christopher goes to kindergarten, I'll go back and get my master's. But Christopher went to kindergarten, and oh, there's Elizabeth and also Alexander. So now I'm like, well, when am I going to be able to do what I want to do? So one big issue for me as a young mother was giving up the things, my dreams, you know, not so much giving them up, but having to put them back, you know, for a little while so that my kids could get the best, you know, my attention. And then as well, like Justin said, you know, I'm really interested in that, those classes. Me and Walter didn't get to take those classes because we were away. You know, we were in Kansas, then we moved to Dallas, and, you know, so we didn't have that opportunity to come back home and get those teachings, which I would prefer for them to be taught here. I probably could have got those teachings somewhere else, but I would rather be here to get those teachings. So, you know, I look forward to that, and, you know, because really right now we have that issue of where are diapers going to come from, because we have two in diapers now. So we're like, where is that money going to come from? And then it's also, you know, pushing your plate back to say, oh, I got to feed my child first. I can't eat first. You know, I love food. So I'm like, wait a minute. But no, so, you know, we have that struggle. And then when Pastor Hill called me, he was also speaking about the evangelist team and about how he wanted to reach out to younger people. And one thing that came to mind is I ran into a couple of my classmates last weekend, which I haven't seen in a while. And she said something to me that kind of struck me like, wow, because she said, she asked me how I was doing, and we talked about us having kids and everything. She was like, you know what? Pretty much all of us who graduated in that class, we all have kids. And I was like, yeah, you know, that's true. And she's like, but only a handful of us are married. She was like, I can tell you're married, before she even asked if I was married. And I was just like, you know, it kind of went over my head. But then as I started to think about it, I was like, how could she just look at me and say, you're married? Like, I didn't understand what she, you know, at first I was just kind of like, let it go in my head. Then I started thinking, you know, it wasn't just the fact that I was married, but she was seeing something else inside of me. So, you know, I think there is a cry out right now for young people to find themselves. And it's not to just be like, oh, I want what Kristen has. I want to be married with my three kids and be happy. No, it's, I want to have that joy that's inside of her. What is that? So, I mean, that's all I have.